Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Kay, and today I'm doing this first impressions, get ready with me, kind of a look thing got going on. Yeah, so let's just get started. I'm starting off by color correcting with this LA Girl Pro Red Concealer, which I've never used before, and apparently don't know how to use it. Okay, which I've never used before, and like, I went ham, okay? Like, ham. I put on a whole bunch. It's very, very dark for my skin tone. I think it's probably darker than me. So, like, next time I use it, I have to use a lot less. But, I mean, I made it work. Then I'm covering it up with some skin tone shade concealer. So, it'll blend in and cover up all those acne marks I have going on. And, like, on my forehead, I like the way it looks there. On the rest of my face, not so much. Moving on to foundation. You guys don't understand, this Beauty Blender was so cold. Okay, the water I used to like wet it was so cold. I'm just blending it in, and it kind of covers up the color correcting I did on my face, and around my mouth, and on the side of my cheek. But I mean, the first layer I put down wasn't really doing it for me because I did thin it out. I don't know why I did that. I don't know what I was thinking because that's usually what I do. So I'm going to have to do for medium coverage, not for full coverage. But then I went ahead and went back with the second layer to deepen or make it more full coverage, if that makes sense. I hope that makes sense. Like you can see on my forehead, like it just covers that color beautifully. So I will in the future do it like that. So I do have my brows already done, and I will be doing a brow tutorial for you guys coming soon, so don't worry about that. And now I'm just adding more foundation or more coverage where I think I need it to cover up that red so it's not poking through. And the red part that's on the bright side of my cheek will get covered up with like contour and concealer and whatever else later on. So then I'm using this new concealer I got. It's a different shade. It's the same concealer, just in different shade. It's in Fawn. And like, I love how yellow tones it is. Oh my god, it's so beautiful. It's gorgeous. So I'm just doing that as I normally do and blending it out. And making it look on my... Like, I think it fits me better than the one I was using last time. The one I was using before was kind of cool toned. It wasn't really working for me the way I wanted it to. So now I'm going in and setting that with my Coty Airspun powder. And I kind of went ham on this too. Like, I'll put so much. I don't know what I was thinking. Like, I kind of pressed it in at first. And then I would make an add some more on top to, like, bake it. But, like, what didn't occur to me at the time was that I was baking before I even contoured. So, yeah, you can see I'm kind of doing it backwards. But I'm going to go ahead and contour after this. I don't know what I was thinking. But like setting my nose, my chin, my forehead, bomb. This powder is so good. I took the powder and I pressed it in, and I like pressed it in with the Beauty Blender, like melted it with my skin. It was bomb, like flawless. I loved the way it set my forehead. It was so good. I just did that to like the other areas, and then it was so nice. It just set it so nice. So like, I think I'm gonna continue to do that, setting it with a wet beauty blend, with a wet beauty sponge, because it just helps the product set your makeup better instead of a dry wet sponge, or instead of a dry wet sponge or a brush. I think I like that technique. Before I finish setting my face, I'm going in and contouring like I normally do with the same concealer that I usually use, but I'm using a Wet n Wild stippling brush, and this is where it went left for me. Like, this brush is really, really soft. It's really good, but like, it spreads product like no other, but it blends so good, which is why it's so confusing for me. Like, on my chin area, it did an okay job. And you'll see over here, like, it just spread the product, like, where I didn't want it to be. So I guess I'll have to use less concealer than I normally do when I'm using this brush or something to make it work. But, like, it blended the concealer on my forehead beautifully. Like, no problems there. But on my cheek, that's another situation going on there because it was odd mess. Or it is odd mess, basically. This brush also does soak up all of it. It's kind of weird. It's like it spreads the product, but then it soaks it up as well. It's a strange phenomenon with the brush, but it's so soft. It blends. Like, it just blends the contour of my forehead so good. So good. Or so well. So that's probably what I'll continue to use it for, is all the perimeters of my face, but not contouring my cheekbones, because that's not gonna happen. It might also be due to the fact that the brush is round and the area I'm trying to contour is more narrow. I don't know, something just didn't work right with this brush and contouring my face when I was doing this. Like, it became a very dark mess on my face. But I will fix it, so don't worry, I don't walk around looking crazy like this. Like, I did fix it up. So then I'm going in using the same like gunpowder to like clean up this contour, because it needs to be cleaned up so bad. Like, it was beyond wild. The brush just spread the product everywhere, so I'm taking this Aerosol powder and like packing it on to make the line super, super sharp. And I'm dusting away with the Wet n Wild contour brush I usually use. But like, you see this powder is everywhere, okay? Like, it was everywhere. But then when I went to brush with the one under the contour, you see like the powder just kind of crumpled up and like, I don't know how you call it, it just like balled up on itself. And I tried to brush away, it left like a white cast, like a white cast. So I changed to a powder brush and my face powder to like really brush it all off of my face and like blend it in, because it was looking crazy. So then moving on to my eyes, I already primed them like I usually do, and I'm going in with this, I went in with the Wet n Wild contour shade of my crease, and I'm taking this dark brown from the Wet n Wild Kami and Latte palette, I think it's called. And I'm just blending that into the outer V into my crease. Like, this eye look is so simple because I wasn't really trying to do a lot. I was being basic. And it's only three shadows. So what I originally wanted to do was take this orange shade right here. It's so pretty. Like, when I swatched it, like, it was pretty. And it matched my little head tie I had going on. This orange one right here. I'm doing the most with this swatching ring ago. And I took a brush and nothing happened. Like, legit nothing happened. But I swiped it on my lid. So then I went back in, I tried it with my finger, and nothing happened. Again, like, no pigmentation. This eyeshadow did not work for the life of me. I cannot get to work on my eyes. So I just, like, gave up and moved on. So then I took the shade next to it, which was a golden-ish shade. I was like, I can make this work with my scarf that I had going on. I mean, I didn't really have anything planned. So I was like, I'm just take this gold one right here and just pack that on lid. And that gave me way better pigmentation and color payoff than that orange one. That orange one was like, it wasn't worth it. And some of the shades in this Wet n Wild palette are like hit and miss. Like, the brown one and the black one, bomb. And this gold one, bomb. That orange one, trash. So for the other side, I just took a little bit of concealer and like added on there to help boost the pigmentation. Because, like, as it was fine, but I want like more. And I want to extra-ish. So I just added a little bit of concealer. Like, I did it in my last tutorial, but like, I didn't do it all super crisp or anything. I was just put a little bit on there. And I went back with my finger, and you can see it gave way better pigmentation. And then the other side, it looks so much better, which is what I was going for, which is with the orange one. But these shadows, I must warn you, have a lot of fallout. And I was using my fingers. So I just lined my eyes, tight line and waterline with a black liner. And now I'm going with this CoverGirl Super Size Mascara. And this wand is amazing. I love it. Helps me get right down to the root of the lashes. So then for blush, I went in with this peach and like mid-tone pink shade. Like, it wasn't too dark, it wasn't too light. It was like a medium pink, yes. And this peach shade, I just mixed them together. So I didn't really want to do like too much blush, but then I wasn't. Yeah, I just went in with blush, basically. I just applied that on my cheeks. I kind of went a little ham on that side. Looking back at it right now, like, that stuff was heavy. I just blended it on my cheeks, my forehead, my nose, and my chin, because I don't like to just put blush on my cheeks. Like, I want my whole face to look. I have some color going on. So I do that. Just kind of spread the extras all around. And then for highlight, I went in with these two shades right here. What is this, like a gold and a deep gold or something? I don't know, they're really pretty. I just mixed them together, and I used this blending brush to put my highlight on, and it was bomb, okay? It was beautiful, just the right amount of highlight that I wanted or that I needed to go on, and it just did it so beautifully. Like, because using a fan brush, sometimes it puts too much in one place. But this blending brush, got the job done for me. But I did take the fan brush to make the highlight pop, like really, really pop on my cheeks, though, because it had to be shining to outer space. Not that much, but I had to be popping. Like a dark lip, like I wanted to do a black lipstick, but I didn't have any, so I had to improvise. So I took this black Wet n Wild liner and went around and lined the outside of my lips, and then I took this black kajal. I think that's how you say it. A kajal eyeliner, and just filled it in. It was super creamy, whatever. So I just filled it in like that, and like, it's a look. Okay? This is a look within itself. I really, really did like this one. Like, I was feeling myself a little bit. For an alternative lip option, I took some glitter because doing the most, and I kind of just, with the narrow side of a wet sponge, did it in the glitter and applied it to my lips, so it created two straight lines. And this was cute. Like, if you just do the bottom lip, that's cute. Both lips, whatever, it was cute. I liked it. And then for the third lip option, I took off the glitter and then I filled it back in with the kajal eyeliner, and then I took the same golden highlight and started packing it on my lips. You can do a little bit, that was cute, but I wanted to be extra and see how far I could go with this. So I packed it on a lot, but then I didn't like that. It didn't really flow with the eyes and with the face, with the head tie. So I made the decision to go with a darker one, because why not? And then I packed that on top of, took the deeper highlight, packed that on top, and that gave me this look right here. Fire. I like this one too. And then for the final option, I just took some more liquid eyeliner and just went around the highlighted lips. And like that just set it off. Like, all of these looks were popping. I loved them. But let me know in the comments down below which look was your favorite. Like, I think I like the black one the best. Like, I would actually leave my house like that. Like, I would go somewhere like that for the fun of it. Like, I don't know why I'm gonna wear glitter lips too, but you know. Yeah, leave me a comment down below. Let me know which look you guys like the best. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, please give a big thumbs up. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you liked. And subscribe to my channel, because you should, why not? Yeah, just subscribe. Thanks. I don't know what's going on with me.